There we go.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Occupy SF TV. This is James reporting from Independent Citizen Media. I'm here with Pirate Mike, Occupy Veterans San Francisco. We are still continuing our march across America, and we've had a fantastic time in this little town of Guadalupe, California. The people here have been really welcoming, and we have a lot to talk about. We're going to keep this broadcast short for 15 minutes because I cannot archive it to YouTube due to their constraints on my account. And Pirate, why don't you take it away and give the viewers a quick update on what we got going on.
Okay. Well, Guadalupe is situated on the central coast of California. It is home to many, many Vietnam veterans and World War II survivors. Interesting point of fact was that during Vietnam, Guadalupe had 300 of its 2,000 citizens volunteer for service. Among them were 56 brothers and quite a large number of women. So we've had a very enthusiastic reception here. We've scheduled a screening for tomorrow night here at the Guadalupe Cultural Arts and Education Center. They've provided facilities for us, and we're looking forward to a pretty good turnout tomorrow night. I breezed through Guadalupe last year on my way to San Francisco, and I found the town in the middle of a depression. Stores were shuttered up. There was nobody on the streets, and I still found a very good vibe here. It's largely an immigrant community, yet it's probably the most American town I've encountered, one of the most American towns I've encountered. The weather is temperate. We're a few miles from the beach. Guadalupe is famous for its sand dunes. Cecil B. DeMille filmed The Ten Commandments here and had the largest film cast and crew in history with 250,000 cast members. When he was done filming, they built huge sets of Babylon and Egypt here on the beach. And when they were done filming, they destroyed it all, and the sand dunes eventually covered it. In the 90s, a guy came and he excavated those ruins, and it forms a major part of the Dunes Historical Center here next door. That exhibit's kind of neat because they went about it like actual Egyptian archaeologists, but it was all film props, but it's still really cool. Giant sphinx heads and things like that. Last night, James and I were able to participate in their annual Christmas parade, which was very sweet. There were hundreds of children running amok in the streets.
And I have pictures that will be uploaded as soon as possible.
Yeah, I think he's got some great shots too. The American Legion allowed us to march with them and the Boy Scouts, which was kind of fun. In the background, I can hear what I believe is the remnants of their Mexican rodeo. Yeah, so far we've been having a great time. We had to bypass Oxnard. We were going to meet up with Occupy Oxnard and try to be in Santa Barbara by today, but I decided that this screening in this town was more important. I'm going to be screening the film, a shortened version of the film, and we have some Native American veterans and from Vietnam and Korea who are going to be speaking about their experiences coming home in that post-war America. As you know, we're not in post-war America today. We are living in a full-blown war economy that is crippling our nation slowly but surely. As a matter of fact, I would amend that statement to say that this war economy is driving our country into the ground at an exceptionally rapid pace. Other than that, the first couple nights we were able to sleep out here.
Right here.
We slept right here.
And
I'll give you a quick view of the center. This is where we slept.
Yep.
We had a fire. We camped out right here.
And then the next morning when the park ranger showed up, he said, "Hey, good morning, guys." And we're like, "Hey, good morning." And he's like, "How'd you sleep last night?" We're like, "No problems. This town is like such the opposite of San Francisco. And last night we were able to hook up with a Catholic workers movement. They were very generous. They've let us kept our gear there. We slept. They have a hospitality house.
We slept indoors.
It was nice.
For the first time in, what, a couple months?
Yeah. Well, since we left, really.
Yeah.
And we were able to cook up some breakfast. And I'm very inspired by the Catholic workers movement. It's an anti-war, pro-poor persons movement. And they have 230 hospitality houses across the United States. And they're very involved with the Occupy movement. They're very involved with the War Resisters League. And it reminded me of my buddy in San Francisco, Father Louis Vitalet, who I had no idea of his historical importance to the peace movement. And I'm proud to be a part of that continuum of peace. And, you know, next stop, you know, naturally will be Santa Barbara, and we're going to try to meet up with the VFP there. But we're getting a positive response everywhere we go. And, I'm quite pleased with our efforts and our progress.
Yes, I must say Mike has done a lot of work contacting people during our journey and for our future stops. And I think that as long as we are able to continue finding free Wi-Fi and places like this, we will be able to post current updates and photos, short videos like this one. And, you know, I really feel it's overwhelming. 1 minute I could be really depressed because things just aren't going right. I'm in pain. My neck's been bothering me. My back's been bothering me. And people have, at least in this town, been very open-hearted and open-handed to welcoming us into their town and wanting to know what we're up to.
Oh, before I forget, James, I know a lot of people have been having some difficulty with the donations on the Occupy Veterans site. You need to go to the support page. Yeah. That button works. The one on the March Across America page doesn't work. We're trying to iron that out. So right now, if you want to make a contribution, go to the support page. We're about $103 away from our $400 goal of getting the bikes replaced. And as a matter of fact, Jorge from Catholic Workers turned me on to some guys who live across the street from City Hall.
Okay.
Who have a garage full of bikes.
Wow.
So I was probably going to go over there later and introduce myself to them. Also yesterday, I went to a memorial service of one of Guadalupe's cornerstone individuals, a man named Joe Oriolo, who served in the Navy during World War II, and he'd recently passed. So there are, you know, we want to honor those veterans wherever we can, in life, in death. We want to honor their service and the sacrifices that these small communities have made to our country. Oh, another cool thing about Guadalupe, no Starbucks, no Walmarts, no Jack in the Box, no fast food. Domino's lasted 6 months. The people just didn't go there. You know, Domino's, hey, you guys need crappy pizza. And no, we don't.
They do have a pizza shop here in town, and it's smells good. We haven't had a chance to try it, but
right. But it's all bodegas and small houses. There was a great lowrider show in the park yesterday for the Boys and Girls Club. They raised money. Little kids running around on lowrider bikes. Reminds me of San Diego, and I can't wait to get to San Diego, you guys. It's going to be awesome. Get James down there in the sun-drenched waves of Ocean Beach. Look at girls in bikinis. It's been a while. And I don't know, I'm just kind of basking in the sun. Feels like it's about 72 degrees. You know, low-lying, you know, high altitude clouds.
And speaking of high altitude clouds, I've been watching all day. There's been discussions about online on Facebook about chemtrails and contrails. today's cloud pattern is a chemtrail cloud pattern. These are nanoparticles that hold the moisture in the air to prevent the sun's rays from reaching the surface and overheating the planet. I watch these planes crisscross all day long, and a contrail will disappear in about 3 minutes. Chemtrails last significantly longer and disperse into these cloud patterns, which I will show you real quick what they look like.
We've been seeing all the C-130 transport planes, troop transports.
You know, it's a high cloud pattern, and you can see the streaking from the planes that have passed by, and the disbursement, how it spreads out.
It was even nastier in San Luis Obispo, where you could actually see that weird, gross petrochemical colors of, like, you know, when water mixes with oil. It's not like a rainbow color. It's got weird colors in it. And that night it rained. They're like, hey, it rained in a coon's age. And then when we were camping out by the river, it was bone dry. And then that day, we saw some planes releasing chemicals in the air, and then I could see in the clouds these colors that I associate with oil puddles in the air, and then that night it rained, and woke up next to a river. It's crazy.
Yeah, it was full. The creek bed was completely dry.
And the next morning,
it was probably a good foot or so deep, and it's not exactly a real wide river or stream bed, but there was a significant amount of rain that came down that night.
The bigger the city, the smaller people's hearts. And I think the smaller the town, the bigger people's hearts are. And that's one of the things that I hope James and I can document, is that the spirit of small town America, I like to call it Mayberry, it is still alive in this country. And I think that's the basis on which we have to rebuild our nation, you know, through the surviving veterans and through that outreach in the churches, in the community clubs, the Rotary clubs, Kiwanis, all these types of things. Despite what people may think about religion and fraternal orders, you know, we've got to bear in mind it's always the leadership that corrupts this. The baseline membership is usually good-hearted, compassionate people who don't really know what's going on above their heads. And, you know, I just wanna thank everybody for following us and for supplying the donations when I needed them for my arm.
The arm's healing.
As you can see, the arm is pretty much healed.
Healed
now. And
the man's bionic.
Big shout outs to Daisy May, who facilitated that. And we could probably use some things for James's neck and back. I don't know what that would be, like.
A chiropractor would be nice.
Yeah. Someone dump us $100 and we can somehow pay a contract.
Real quick, Mike, you mentioned the PayPal on your website. The PayPal buttons on my website, independentcitizenmedia.weebly, are the exact same button that Mike uses on his Occupy Veterans SanFrancisco.weebly.com website, and those should be working. I tested them for configuration that it does link to the proper place. And
welcome, viewer.
We want to thank everybody that has made donations, and we really appreciate it. We will be getting those bikes as soon as possible to continue our journey, not on foot, but by pedal power.
Yeah.
We're looking at about 14 minutes. We want to wrap this up so it can be archived to YouTube with that 15-minute maximum limit that I have. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. Don't forget to check out the websites, independentcitizenmedia.weebly.com and
OccupyVeteransSanFrancisco.weebly.com. So remember, if you're having problems on my site, just shuttle those donations to his. And big shout-outs to Carol Harvey, who's doing a great job.
Thanks, Carol.
Covering the story for us and disseminating that online and in the print media.
Thanks for tuning in. We'll be shouting out at you again as soon as possible when we have more updates.
Peace.
Peace and love.
Nice.